Hitler's phone operator, SS officer Rochus Misch, is the only surviving witness to what happened that day. On the afternoon of April 30th, 1945, Hitler and Eva Braun are left alone with two loaded pistols and vials of poison.
We were all quiet. Everyone just listened. And then somebody called, "I think it is time." After the door was open, I saw Hitler and Eva. She was lying on the couch. I still remember this image today.
Eva Braun had taken poison. Most believed Hitler shot himself, but neither Misch nor any other witnesses actually examined him. Could he have also swallowed cyanide, as the Russians claim?
Hitler was so terrified of being captured by the Russians, not wanting to leave anything to chance, he decided to do the two things simultaneously, shooting himself and taking the poison.
The poison may not have killed Hitler instantly.
Cyanide kills you because it attaches itself to parts of the blood usually used to get the oxygen that you breathe in into your system. Your body continues to breathe very deeply, like very, very deeply, but it doesn't help you anymore.
Hitler may still have had time to pick up his pistol and fire. Adolf Hitler never tried to flee Berlin. He continued his wanton path of destruction until he brought down everything he claimed to hold dear, even Germany.
He actually believed that Germany should die with him. He was its incarnation. He was going to commit suicide. Germany should die too.
Even Hitler's last orders called for destruction of his own body. Aides, now deceased, have described what happened. The men carry Hitler's corpse to the garden above the bunker. They soak it with 50 gallons of gasoline. Their orders are to cremate it completely, so Stalin can never put it on display. But with war raging just beyond the garden walls, the men are forced to take shelter before the job is done. From the bunker garden, Hitler's body begins a bizarre, decades-long odyssey. Retired KGB agent Sergei Kondrashov has only recently come forward to explain that mystery and why he helped hide the truth for 50 years.
At that time, there were people who did not want to give up finding the remains and maybe erecting a shrine.
Joseph Stalin could have destroyed his greatest enemy forever, but he didn't. Instead, he had his men hang on to the body.
They didn't know how to play it. Nothing was said about the discovery of Hitler's body, so they had to keep it secret. At the same time, they might change their policy and suddenly want to put it on show to the rest of the world to show that they did have it.
The Red Army stashes Hitler's remains in an ammunition box and buries them. They fear someone might find the body. It becomes a proverbial hot potato. When the soldiers switch bases, they dig Hitler up and they take him with them. Hitler is exhumed and reburied as many as 8 times. Not until 1970 does Adolf Hitler disappear for good. When Russia abandons these military barracks in Magdeburg, Germany, where he is buried, Moscow orders Sergei Kondrashov, now KGB chief in East Berlin, to dig up Hitler one last time.
The boxes were finally removed, burnt to the state of ashes, and thrown into the sewer.
From there, an East German river carried Adolf Hitler out to sea. Hitler's bunker in Berlin is also no more. Imploded by the Russians in 1947, it is now a parking lot. Just a stone's throw from Berlin's memorial to victims of the Holocaust. Today, most of us readily accept that Adolf Hitler died in Berlin in 1945. Yet millions once feared him so much, the idea of his escape struck terror in their hearts. And today, in some ways, he still lives. Hitler remains a messiah of a few on the extreme right, and he haunts the nightmares of the rest of us.
The world really never got its revenge. If you kept him alive, there's always the chance to somehow get even with him.
The willingness to believe in Adolf Hitler's escape is a testament, not to whether it could have happened, but to the overwhelming magnitude of his crimes.